Hey guys, welcome back to another episode of Creatnprocess. In today's video, we'll look at how you can create out this glossy mesh object using Illustrator, and then we'll look at how you can apply a nice texture to it in Photoshop using various blending options. So let's begin the designing process. In the previous video, we have seen how you can create the mesh object using the mesh tool in Illustrator and apply some light color tone, and seen how you can create various versions of shapes using the artwork option. In today's tutorial, we'll create out this glossy object, and to create that, first of all, we need to apply the base color. So select these shapes and just pick a simple plain color from the object like that. And after that, now we'll add some shades to it. So as you can see on the other side or the ends, let's add these glossiness. So I'll just pick the color, pick the anchor points using the dice selection tool, just select these anchor points and select this as well, and with the eye picker tool, pick bright color from here, and this will add that nice glow effect to there. Select these anchor points and just pick some like faded color from here like that, just to blend it like that. And for the last row, select these rows and with the eye picker tool, just pick something like this, just to make sure they are properly aligned like that, just to give that darkness. And if you check it over here, you can see it's softly blended, and here you can see some sharpness. So just to make sure it's properly blended, just select this anchor points and just pick some faded, a little bit just to blend it properly, just make a blended faded color similar to that, like that. And here, selecting these anchor points, just pick some little bit of darker just to blend it nicely like that. And here, just tweak the colors a little bit of like that, and this will give you that nice sharp end over there. So it's all about mixing the color properly, how you mix it using the color tone, that gives you a nice color effect. So here I need that darkness, but a little bit of similar to that, and this gives you nice glow effect over there. And now if you go on the other side, let's do the same. So let's select these anchor points, and as you can see, it's to the bottom of it. So I just select all these anchor points over here, and with the eye picker tool, just pick the color. So pick the color from here, this one, light, and over here we need to blend it with the red color. So let's select these anchor points and let's pick this reddish color tone, just to blend it nicely like that. And now we'll work over here. So as you can see, this is similar to this, but over here we need to blend it nicely. So I'll just select these anchor points and pick a color which is a little bit mid range between them like that, and it will blend it like that. And here I think this looks good. Over here I need a path of a bright color, so just pick, just select these anchor points over here, and I'll just pick some bright color. So just select them and apply the brightest tone over here. And after that, over here we'll just try to blend it with the range of the color. So just select these anchor points and just try to blend it similar to that color, and as you can see, it will nicely blend similar to that. And here as well, I'll try to blend it a little bit. So just selecting these anchor points and make sure it's not that much blended, we need that darkness as well. So just going a little bit just like that. I think overall it's looking great. Over here I need to do some little bit of blending, so I'll pick this color and pick the little brighter tone like that, just to make it glow over there, and it's looking great. So just adding a little bit of brightness and playing around with the shade gives you that interesting look, giving a feel of 3D depth. And what we can do more is, I'll just select these anchor points and just go there and just pick a color similar to that. Over here on top portion, we have added some little glow to it. So pick this anchor point and I'll add some lighter tone. I'll just pick the color from somewhere around here just to fade the color like that. So here we go, we have added that. And at this corner, it's very softly blended, but over here, you can see it's very sharp. So just to make sure it's softly blended, select that, pick a color similar to that. Do the same over here as well, just to make sure it's nicely softly blended. Here as well, soft blend. And that way, we can give that nice effect. Now for the top and the lower region, we have given the gradient color, but if you want, you can directly just tweak this, select these anchor points, just select the dark color and just select these anchor points and apply some bright color if you want, like that, just to give some interesting feel to it. And we can do the same as well. So for here, I'll just pick this gradient color, and if I go there and this is the color code, it's linear, I'll just change the angle to this, similar to that, like this. And if you check out the color code, this is the color code, and for the brighter color I have used this color code, and for the other end, this is the color code I have used. And for this design, I have used different cap, but you can use the similar cap as well, but it's the same technique. This one is a little basic. Over here, I have just used the gradient color simply and nothing else, and created this cap. Over here, we have used the mesh tool, and it gives you that interesting look. So I think this looks great. We'll keep it like this way. Now we'll select these and just drag and drop it to Photoshop. So just open a new Photoshop document. I set it to 1500 by 900 and create it. Now drag and drop it. But before that, make sure that this object is slightly a little bit extended downward. Same goes for here as well. Just make sure a little bit extended upward and downward, just to reduce that gap in the Photoshop. So select them and just drag and drop it to Photoshop. And here is our object. Just scale down the size a little bit and place it somewhere around here. Now this is our final output, which we're going to create, and this is the beginning of our design. So let's begin. Let's increase the size a little bit and enter, and I'll create two more duplicates like this and just place it below our design like that, and just scale down the size a little bit. So just select them and reduce the size and place it somewhere around there. Now for the first design, let's add a new text. So I'll just type our text and just scale up the size and change the color to white. Let's choose some bold text, just this, and let's align them like this. Let's scale up the size, and I'll create one more text and just place it somewhere on here. Scale down the size, enter, just change the text, come on, control it, Illustrator, and I'll just scale down the size. So after that, I'll just clip this to our object like this. We can convert this into a smart object and change the blend mode to soft light and create one more duplicate just to give that highlight a little bit. And now to apply texture, it's very simple. If you check out over here, this is the texture we have applied to it, and the blending mode we have used is soft light, and that's all. So what we'll do is, first of all, let's bring that layer. I'll just select this and bring in over here, place this on top of it. I'll create one more and place it somewhere around here like this, and we have changed the color to white. So let's change the color. Just go there, color overlay, change the color to white and click OK. And it's already hard light, so it's fine. Do the same for the other. Just click create a duplicate and place it somewhere there. And now to apply a texture, I have got a texture over here, this one. I'll just drag it over to over here. You can bring in any texture. I just love this texture and place it over here and just clip it to our object. So as you can see, this is our second object. So I just place this texture just above it and apply clipping mask, and after that change the blend mode to soft light, and that way you can easily apply any texture to it like this. And bring in one more texture for our second object. So I'll just select this, bring in and change the blend mode to soft light and apply it, and just place it somewhere around there. And if you want to do some adjustment with the color, you can just go there, apply hue and saturation, and edge, play around with the color tone, just map it and adjust the color combination like this. For this also, you can apply a color like that, clip it, so adjust the hue saturation, and you can give some different color effect similar to that. So this is how I have created this nice cool effect. Lastly, what we can do is we can like select them, group them up, like select them as well, this, group them up Do the same for the third object, group them up, and after that we'll create a duplicate of it. Convert to smart object and command control T, just create a object like this, enter on the bottom. Do the same for the second and third, create a duplicate, convert them to smart object, command control T, and just drag them on the bottom like this. Create a duplicate of it, smart object, command control T, drag them down like this. After that, drag them all the three on the bottom, select them all and reduce the opacity a little bit, somewhere around like that, and group them up. You can give some gradient color, so apply a mask and apply some gradient color just like this. Just pick a color, okay, and just click and drag just to apply some gradient color. And after that, you can just move around the gradient, scale up the size, and you can just play around with the gradient color. You're adding a like feel of drop shadow. So this way we have created out this nice mesh object using Adobe Illustrator Photoshop. We have seen how you can create a mesh object using the mesh tool. We have used the color tones, various color shades to give the 3D feel to the object. We have created two types of object. The first object is using the light version and the second object is with the darker version, which is glossy. The first version was little lighter tone, and after that we have seen how we can apply texture using the blending option in Photoshop. If you have a color object and you want to change into black and white or a white color, you can use the artwork object just to do that. We have seen how you can use blending options such as hue and saturation, curve option just to change the color tone. I hope you enjoyed this tutorial. Don't forget to check out the next tutorial coming up, and if you want more updates on designing, don't forget to like, share and subscribe this channel. Thank you.